Tonight, Norfolk police are working to find out who shot and killed a man last night in Ocean View.
Suspected gang members are off the streets tonight and behind bars. They made their first court appearance in federal court in Norfolk.
Including murder and attempted murders, assaults with dangerous weapons, armed robberies, and illegal drug distribution.
You have a prepaid call. You will not be charged for this call. This call is from
Mikal Mix,
an inmate at federal prison. This call is being recorded and is subject to
Stash DB, man, Dirty Boy from Ocean View. Stash, I got that from some niggas in New York when I was little. Like, we used to always just get chased by the police or whatever, and I used to always get away, so I don't know, my older cousin started calling me that one day, and that shit just stuck, you know what I'm saying? Dirty Boy, like, I got that when I came to Virginia, like, just honestly from doing bullshit, you know what I'm saying? Niggas just used to, I got that name from Marlo, you know what I'm saying? So he started calling me BB and shit, so that's where that came from. 92. Yeah, I moved out there with my moms and my sisters in 1992. My brother's out. It's like right by the Bronx, man. It's like, it was a lot of fun out there. You feel me? Like, I was sick when I first had to move to Virginia. Like, I was mad about that shit. You know, the funny shit is they used to call Norfolk Little New York. They used to call that because it's so many New York dudes out there. Naughty by Norfolk. They had a bunch of little nicknames for it, but I always just call it Norfolk City. You know what I'm saying? But that's the most that I really remember. I remember they used to call Norfolk Little New York. Ocean View, like one long ass strip. You feel me? They call it Ocean View because it's a beach right there. Like, along the whole strip of Ocean View, it's a beach. You know what I'm saying? And it stretched probably about, about almost 70 blocks. You feel me? It's like, it's a good hood. Like, it's like, it's one of the biggest hoods in Norfolk. You feel me? But it's like, it got its good part, it got its fucked up part. I love Ocean View, man. Like, Ocean View, alright, man. Dude, it was a lot of dudes out there that was really putting on, making noise, like, when I was coming up. Ray and Reggie, Monty, R.I.P. my man Tony Rome, my man Weeda, rest in peace. You know, but mostly like Ray and Reggie and them, man. Like, them was dudes who I looked at. Like, I used to see them coming through. Even Marlo, you know what I'm saying? Like, his name was ringing for a lot of me when I was a little dude. You know what I'm saying? As a matter of fact, on some G shit, I remember when I came down with some of my mans and we would walk around like this when I was younger. So dudes is like flagging and all that. So, well, I remember dudes would see me and they would look at us like we was crazy. Like, yo, like, what the fuck are these niggas doing? You know what I'm saying? Like, they used to bug dudes out. Like, some dudes even pull up on us like, yo, we y'all in some type of gang or something? You know what I'm saying? So when I first came, I never seen it. I never seen it at all. Man, I probably was about, what, 17, 16, something like that. Dudes I was dealing with real hard, dudes I looked up to. You know what I'm saying? It was like a couple of them. And I remember my man went up north in New York, and when he came back home, he was explaining it to me. You know what I'm saying? So it was just me being or knowing dudes and looking up to certain dudes that's how they was moving. So it made me want to move like that, too.
Straight like that, double-lated, life struggles. My man Paul, my man E.K.E. Melly on, everybody, we here. It's official. Y'all better pick y'all rap game up. Other than that, man. Four minute video center. Y'all get right. Yes. First photo shoot. Multimedia, man. This is how we doing that, man.
I used to look up to dudes like Pete Rock and CL. They was from my block and my was from my and my Vernon. They used to hang with my uncles and shit. So basically, Pete Rock and CL Smooth, this kid named Spunk Bigger. I used to listen to a lot of like local dudes. My older brother and Gun, he was the first one. I remember he had like a little. He had went to the studio and booming when I was a kid, and he had made this song. And he used to write my raps for me. This like when I was like in middle school. This probably like I can't even remember the years. I'm bad with years, but I was like in middle school. He used to write my rhymes for me, so that was around, I want to say, about 2001. Actually, I'm going to keep it funky. It was my man Swift. He was from New York. He came down, and he had the name Thug Related. And I just took that shit and ran with it because he started, you know, I was dealing with him, so I took it and just put the brotherhood. You had me, you had Swift De Niro, my cousin Melion, Cody. My man Lil J, Joe Ski, and Juan B, rest in peace, and his brother Juice. And my man Spit It Out, too. Yeah, those were the original members right there. Yeah, you had Flame, Horse, the Death the Gun Gang, you know what I'm saying? Some of my niggas, like, I used to really play they shit. Flame and the Gun Gang, like, them niggas was official. They still out there doing their thing, though. Then you have Losi and the Corner Boys. Losi used to be TRB too, but them was like the main niggas, like as far as like dudes that won't sound or nothing. Like them was the dudes that was making noise for real. Yeah, I met Lance through my man Skino. Lance was a cool dude, man. He was just real like humble, like a real quiet dude. That's what made me like him. Like he wasn't no loud dude. You feel me? And I remember we shot the With Your Hood Like video. That's when I really got to chop it up with him, you know what I'm saying? Like, I always know him, but I got to know him that day. And
this call is from a federal prison.
And, like I said, he ended up dying probably a couple weeks after that, man. He died before the video came out. It's one part where, I always remember he had, like, a green shirt on. It's, like, a part of the video where, like, I'm on the wall and I'm rapping. And he got like a green shirt on, he's dancing around. Like if you really pay attention, you'll see him, he was standing right next to me. You know what I'm saying? Like he had like a green shirt on, if I'm not mistaken. It was me, him, and one of my relatives. My relative had like, he was like a kind of chubby kid, ain't had no shirt on, had the red bandana around his neck. But Lance is around in that scene where I'm in between the two buildings. For real, Lance was like, that night he was like a peacemaker to that whole situation. He was trying to calm things down between two different hoods, you know what I'm saying? And I guess when dudes got the wild and the shot went off, he got hit. Like I was there that night, but like I said, I was on crutches. So I remember my man and him was like, yo, like when I pulled up to the parking lot, that's when they was all going in the party. They came up to the car and was like, bro, just don't even, you know what I'm saying? You shouldn't even be in here like that. So I was leaving. But from what I understand, it was dudes who was there, dudes who actually got locked up for that incident, you know what I'm saying? Like from their mouth before they went to jail, they was telling me like, bro was trying to just calm the situation down. That's just how he was. He was like a peacemaking type dude. Like he wasn't for the blood on blood violence type shit, you know? And that shit erupted between homies at first and shit just got out of hand, you know what I'm saying? And shorty lost his life. Like that shit was fucked up though. I met Lo through some crazy shit. Like he already knew my sister. Like my older sister was cool with him. But I met Lo through some crazy shit. We was like whooping some nigga ass and he came over there and broke it up, and that's when I know him. And then I had my man Doughboy, he had a CD that Lo had put out. My man Quest was rapping. So I remember I had the CD, I used to always listen to it. So then one day, like how I really got to fucking with Lo, I was in a club one time. It was a club called Maxi's. I think he had Maxi's in Virginia Beach. And I seen him at the bar. I was just walking. I'm walking through. It was like a party. It was like a young kid club. So I seen his son at the bar, and I just walked up to him and like grabbed him and I rapped in his ear like out of nowhere. I know he's looking at me crazy like, what the fuck is this nigga? But I met him that night. Like once I just rapped for him, like we started off on some music shit, and that nigga just became like he became one of my best friends. You know what I'm saying? I ended up becoming more tight with Lo, because we was together every day. That was like my right-hand man. Like, we was like best friends, like I said. shit. But I knew Bone before all of them. I met Bone when I first came to Virginia. I met Bone like in the 90s. When we was real little, we lived in Ocean Air, out Ocean View or whatever. And I met BG through my ex-girl's little brother. BG was like one of my little homies, you know what I'm saying? Like, I put him on or whatever. And but I ended up becoming closer with Lo, feel me? Because we was around the same age. He was a little older, though. Yeah, the Ocean thing happened. Really, like, from your first question, like, shit got real bad, I say around, like, the end of 06. That's when, like, so much shit was happening. It was just, like, me personally, I ain't gonna lie, bro. Like, I knew it was only a matter of time for niggas to go to jail for some dumb shit. But with the, when the Ocean View thing happened, when dude got killed, I remember I got picked up for that shit. Mind you, so my daughter, my nigga, all my kids, all my dead homies, I didn't know nothing about it. I never knew nothing about it. I wasn't there. I had nothing to do with it. I don't even know how the fuck I got charged with it. But when that shit happened, being it happened in Ocean View, they just came and grabbed me. That's why actually why I ended up, it got thrown out in the state. Because, you know, the state, you really need proof of shit. You know what I'm saying? When the feds came, we got indicted by the feds like in February of 08. I got picked up for that Ocean View thing September 19th, 2007. And I was charged with that, but that's what really, like, was downhill spiral for everything right there, that incident on 16th day. I was at home, and my girl at the time, she had left out. She left out the house with, matter of fact, a VIP to the homie Suge. She left out with Suge, and they grabbed my girl, and they grabbed Suge on the corner. They thought Suge was me. So they took the keys from her. When they found out that Suge wasn't me, they ran in the crib, kicked the crib, and like on some military shit, like SWAT team or types of shit. So they came in on some bullshit when they came and grabbed me. But they was looking for Max initially, but they had said that day I got indicted by the state grand jury for that murder on 16th day. I was 29. And right before my 30th birthday, I was 29, bro. Nah, I never been to the pen. I only been to Norfolk City Jail a bunch of times, you know what I'm saying? Like a couple times for like bullshit. Never nothing too major. Yeah, these are my first serious joints, man. They set a nigga down, too. Plain and simple, Marlo started testifying. Like, Marlo took a deal, went to the grand jury on me, and they came back, had a 100-count indictment. And that's when the superseding was over. That's when I knew something was wrong with dude when we went to court one day and he just wasn't with us. You know what I'm saying? So that's when the superseding indictment came from him. Specifically just him. For me personally, yeah, it was like I knew dudes who went to the feds, but as far as for me, like, I never knew nobody to go through it like how we went through it. You know what I'm saying? Like, the way they came and the way they grabbed everybody and the way that shit was on the news and in the papers, like, I never even been through nothing close to that. You know what I'm saying? My lawyer came and told me. Actually, I didn't even believe him. You know what I'm saying? Like, I didn't even believe him. When he came and told me that Lo was going in on me, I actually looked at him like, yo, you lying. Like, you're not serious. You feel me? Like, I couldn't even, I couldn't believe that shit. You feel me? This is like my brother. You know what I'm saying? He called my mother mommy. You feel me? My daughter called him Uncle Marlo. You know what I'm saying? So, it just fucked me up. Like, I didn't even believe it. Then when Bone was doing it, I'm like, damn, like, I knew Bone longer than everybody. So, that fucked me up, too. You know what I'm saying? Like, it took me a lot of weeks to realize that them niggas was really going in. You feel me? Our trial was about 2 weeks. 2 weeks, and they deliberated for like a few days, if I'm not mistaken. Yo, when we first walked in there, that's the scariest shit you could ever go through. You feel me? For like to know, like you literally fighting for your life. So I remember walking in there, and it's like we the only black faces in there. And I remember it was just cold. It was cold as fuck. And I'm looking at all these white people. I'm like, damn, like we really in trouble. Like that. That's when that shit hit me, like, yo, this shit is serious, you know what I'm saying? This shit is really serious. That shit was just, like, quiet and cold, and best way to explain it, bro. Quiet, cold, and white faces. That shit is weird. Like, that's the only way I could explain that shit. That shit was like a dream, I mean. I don't got this in my mind. You feel me? They was even talking about going to get my mother. But when they grabbed her, I understood what it was for. But, you know, I knew that, like, they was taking hostages, man. So they was just basically like, all right, we can't get them to tap out. So we're going to finish about to save this girl. or we're gonna get her to flip on him. But, you know, that shit didn't work on either side, you feel me? Like, I knew Shorty wasn't gonna go in on me, and she knew that I wasn't able to, you know what I'm saying, do nothing crazy to save her. So she was cool with it, I was cool with it, we just rumbled, you feel me? Yeah, I'm gonna say, what, like 95% of it, he testified on us for 2 days. He was on the stand for 2 whole days, you know what I'm saying? It was other people that testified too, but he did a lot of damage, like basically, like, you know, and honestly, dude didn't even, I can't even really be telling people that he snitched on me. Dude just lied on me, you know what I'm saying? I guess that is mine, but the more time he gives me, you feel me, like I'm his enemy or something, the more time he gives me, the less time he would get, you know what I'm saying? So, bro just did some bullshit, like, you know, he was facing life. He ended up getting, he got 19 years, they ended up giving him 19 years, and they gave Bone 20. I got found guilty on 16 counts. BG got found guilty on like 52 counts or something like that. So basically they gave me 8 life sentences, they gave BG 7. You know what I'm saying? That's basically what happened. Yeah, that I know 100%, you know, stood tall as far as I know, you know, Little Nene, you know what I'm saying, Michelle, my homegirl Iggy, my man Slim, Dre Ski, Lil Max, Zay. I think them the ones who basically I've never heard nothing bad about at all. You know what I'm saying? Like, I be hearing rumors here and there about certain shit, but I don't got no facts on it. But you feel me? As far as those other ones that I know is like straight up solid. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, that was Zay. That was Lil Zay. He in the feds with me now. CK is still in the state, but Zay, I think he had 2 hung jury at first or something like that. And then when the feds picked it up, he copped out to 35. He got 35 years. He was actually just my cellie when we was in Allenwood. He came out to school. He was my cellie for like 27 days. By the time you realize people are not who they are, it's going to be too late. You know what I'm saying? Like, if you feel like you can't deal with the consequences of your actions and what you do, then just ain't nothing wrong with being a square, man. Ain't nothing wrong with being a legal person. And just,
this call is from a federal prison.
You know what I'm saying? I do the coulda, shoulda, wouldas every night, man. I got 1,001 regrets, you feel me? So that's basically what I'll tell them, man. Just think hard, long and hard before you want to walk on that side, because all they got to do is get you one time for some bullshit and it's a wrap, you feel me? So that's basically what I would tell them, man. Just choose your friends wisely, man, and make sure that the moves you make are the moves you want to make, and you can deal with will come along with the moves that you make, you feel me? Oh yeah, definitely. I was in USB Coleman, man. I remember that day like it was yesterday, you feel me? Like, I remember that phone call. I remember that day perfectly. Yeah, that fucked me up when Shorty died, especially the way that he died. You know what I'm saying? That crushed me too, man. It's like, I lost a lot of people since I've been gone, but, you know, losing Shug and losing Flo and my little niece, like, dumb, that's me right there that fuck with me every day. Like, sometimes that shit don't even feel like it's real because I was there to, like, go to the funerals, I guess, you know what I'm saying? So it's like, that them 3 deaths bother me all the time. That joint before was real hard for me. Definitely considering the way he died, you know what I'm saying? I know they just put out a TRB album called Stash. They named it after me. Stand Tall and Stay Honorable. You got my nephew J Mix. Then you got my man Lights. And it's another kid named J-Bo. I never got to meet J-Bo yet, but I think he got something coming out too. So they definitely still grinding. They keeping TRB alive. Like, I'm definitely proud of them for that. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, I'm writing books now. I got a publishing company that we about to start. It's called Rebus.
This call is from a federal prison.
It stands for Realizing Every Book is Special. And me and my man Black gonna be doing that. And I still got the TRB thing with Tad Al. So that's basically the main thing I'm doing. I'm just concentrating on writing books right now. Like, I got 3 finished, so I want people to definitely be waiting on that. It's called Loyalty and Betrayal. The first one is Loyalty and Betrayal. And it's loosely based on, you know what I'm saying, my situation and what I went through, you know what I'm saying? Yeah, man, I just want to, shout out everybody who just been riding with me, man, you know what I'm saying? It's so many, like, if I can't remember everybody, man, just blame it on my head, not my heart, you feel me? Like, but, my family, my moms, my sisters, Bean, India, Ashley, my man Tadal, my man Crook, my homegirl Bo, one of the most loyal motherfuckers I ever met in my life. It's everybody, man. Everybody who always just keep me alive. Everybody who still love a nigga. Everybody who just still standing with me, man. So I definitely appreciate y'all for that. Rest in peace to Juan Briggs and Lil Berto and Tony Rome and my man Mike. Everybody who's just, people know who I love, man. And I know who love me, man. So I just appreciate that, Definitely my daughter Naya too, man. Like, that's my heart, man. So that's basically it, man. Yeah, they used to play that joint right there. It was another joint called Jungle. Then I used to have Jack Space always play that joint. That What Your Hood Like joint was like the biggest joint I had, man. What your hood like? Go hard or go home. Get lonely, fire and clear. I'm blind when you hear them shots. It's like 24/7, 365. I'ma give it to them straight, pure white. What your homies like? Man, dumb boys, straight up monsters. Revolvers, big ass choppers. Who you squad be? Brotherhood gang, that's who we is. Don't come around here with that sweet shit. It's for the niggas that grind all day long. Stack, they change up. Get knocked, stick to the hoes, don't change up. Stash is the same OG. Never ran, never will. If it's on with the squad, then it's real. Give 2 fucks how any of y'all feel. Guns out, hoodies on, y'all know the drill. Hands up, don't move, homie, just chill. These slugs do burn, chump, that's real. And I don't give leg shots that I don't care for. Dirty boy ain't high dog like the Air Force. Brotherhood, you know how we ride. Chopper shells will lead a passenger on the driver's side. A lot of niggas keep on talking like it can't happen. Like them brotherhood boys just all about rapping. Like I won't take this hammer and straight up smack me. We could get it poppin', dog, let's shot it. So what your hood like? Go hard or go home. Get low and they firing. Clear the block when you hear it. What shots you like? 24/7, 365. I'ma give it to them straight, pure white. What your homies like? Man, dumb boys, straight up monsters. Revolvers, big ass choppers. Who you squad be? Brotherhood gang, that's who we is. Don't come around here with that sweet shit. Ayo, I stays on the ground with my heat out here. Cause the price of life is real cheap out here. Them boys staying all black and love to creep out here. You get killed for trying to think shit is sweet out here. Whatever, I'm trying to get it, gotta eat with the rest of them banged out. And I survive war with the best of them. I ain't too friendly, gotta keep that ratchet. Niggas can cause slip and end up in that casket. I ain't trying to go that route there. I'm trying to get this money up and get my fam out here. 9-5 won't cut it, gotta move them brands. Getting locked, getting murdered, ain't part of the plan. Yo, you niggas gotta feel me, shit serious, fam. The graveyard, the penitentiary is full of my mans. To my niggas in the hood, still locked and loaded. And the ones behind bars who back it. What your hood like? Go hard or go home. Get low and they firing. Clear the block when you hear them. What your hustle like? 24/7, 365. I'ma give it to them straight, pure white. What your homies like? Man, dumb boys, straight up monsters. Revolvers, big ass choppers. Who you squad be? Brotherhood gang, that's who we is. Don't come around here with that sweet shit. A couple niggas out here ain't got no morals. Ratting on niggas that'll show out for you. Can't see how you dudes even look in the mirror. Can't see how your mommy even come stand near you. A lot of good niggas went down for the bullshit. Moving on fast in a rush to be a hood rich. For me, I'ma grind real slow like a love song. Whatever it takes, as long as my dough's long. Feed my family, so on and so on. Roll my haze and smoke my lungs gone. It's in my bones, I'ma hustle for real. Any nigga got a problem, I'll touch it for real. Any nigga don't like it, motherfuck on your head. Cause the shotty show you niggas how I do that there. Yo, it's brotherhood, homie, I'ma stamp it on the game. I'm a beast to the grave.
24/7, 365. I'ma give it to them straight pure white. What your homies like? Man, dumb boys, straight up monsters. Revolvers, big ass chop. Who your squad be? Brotherhood gang, that's who we is. Don't come around here with that sweet shit.
Is different. I gotta feed my children. I'm thinking of the quickest way just to make a million bucks ball. pop out and make them run like a nosebleed. Ain't no running, I'm dumping until you catch a slow leap. I'm a lion in the jungle, he a slow feast. Give him nightmares, wake up and slow sleep. No two pots, two glocks, we gon' hit him up. Chopper hit him, you see his body and soul splitting up. I used to be that young wild nigga, ain't never give a fuck. Realize I humble myself and be a bigger pup. Niggas wanna ride the wave but can't manage it. Tech 9 get the kicking, boy, it's dismantling. Punch lines leave them so scarred, they so damaging. This is no sleep, my nigga, can you handle it? When you up all night, can't get no rest, nigga. Got the world on your shoulders and you a wreck, nigga. When you down to your last, like what's left, nigga? Just know that God made the hard times for the best, niggas. When you up all night, can't get no rest, nigga. Got the world on your shoulders and you a wreck, nigga. When you down to your last, like what's left, nigga? Just know that God made the hard times for the best, niggas.